Come to a world filled with reduced Shakespeare company magic, where literary characters come to life. Huckleberry Finn, Don Quixote, Hester Prynne, the Invisible Man, Captain Ahab, Odysseus, the Cyclops, Molly Bloom, Long John Silver, Frankenstein, Oliver Twist, D'Artagnan, Stephen Dedalus, Sherlock Holmes, Ebenezer Scrooge, the Brothers Karamazov, and Tess, Tess of the D'Urbervilles. The Reduced Shakespeare Company returns to its literary roots with its latest hilarious stage show, All the Great Books Abridged.
Now, class, what do we mean by the great books?
An epic sweep through all of Western literature. A tiny Tennyson, a short Longfellow, a thin Thoreau, reduced Proust.
Wait a second. Lord of the Rings isn't on here.
Nope, nor is the Communist Manifesto.
That's right, no fantasy.
And a little Dickens.
Please, sir, may I have some more?
Bah! Humbug!
Well, then may I leave early, sir? It's Christmas Eve.
I suppose you want Christmas Day off as well.
If it's convenient.
It is not convenient.
If you do not give me the time off, I'll be forced to reveal your dark secret to all of Port Charles.
Which dark secret?
That you and Jacob Marley were more than just business partners.
Damn that Jacob Marley! And that bottle of champagne!
Of course, every little Dickens needs a little women.
Now, in the book Little Women, the mother is named Marnie, which is short for Marmalade, because she's an extremely sweet woman, as well as the coach and general manager. And she's assembled a very strong team with Meg, Amy, Beth, Edith, Tamara, Venus, Serena, and Flojo, the book's narrator. Now, as the novel begins, the Little Women have lost their best player, their father, to free agency. The Civil War has broken out, and he signed with the Yankees. The little women are now a player down. Fortunately, the boy, Laurie, lives next door. He's an orphan, a free agent. The Little Women sign him, and the league allows it because, let's face it, Laurie, girl's name. Now, at this point, the Little Women get two pieces of bad news. First, they learn that Beth has run a down-and-out to help the down-and-out family down the street, whose infant has scarlet fever. Beth herself catches scarlet fever and is penalized 15 yards and her life. They also learn that the father has been taken ill and placed on the disabled list. At this point, the Little Women reacquire the father, nurse him back to health by pumping him full of steroids, and he goes on to hit 73 home runs as the Little Women win the World Series. Now, the Little Women are so successful because their four best players are Meg, Amy, Edith, and Tamara. That's right, there is no I in team and no you in win. And all the Little Women live happily ever after.
But how did all the great books abridged come to life?
Well, first, we had to read every single book ever published.
Yeah, I mean, that took, you know, well, we had to join the Library of Congress.
Right.
And that, all the bureaucracy's crazy.
There's so much paperwork.
Yeah. And then, yeah, and to read every single book ever published, I mean, that took us like a week and a half. I mean, it was crazy.
All the great books you should have read in high school but probably didn't come to life in this fast, funny, physical family adventure. Not afraid of sacred cows or sparkling intellectual debate.
I'm not illiterate! My parents were married!
This three-member cast of thousands revels in pure, irresistible, reduced Shakespeare company magic. But of course, some great books didn't make the cut.
Moby Dick, I didn't care for as much. Well, it has the word dick in the title, and I just don't think that's appropriate for a family show.
I don't know. I mean, there's a lot of material, some pretty big books. I was a little scared. I was a little intimidated.
Don't be intimidated by the great authors. They were regular guys. They put their pants on one leg at a time.
What about Jane Austen?
She put her dress on one leg at a time.
Gertrude Stein?
Not sure.
I had a great time. In fact, there's a lot of things that I learned that I didn't know before.
Now, we all know that Plato wrote a lot of great books, right? But what he's really best known for is that soft molding clay that bears his name.
Some people say, must you have read these books to enjoy the show? Absolutely not. No. I mean, we didn't read any of them.
Yeah. Which I think is its biggest selling point.
One thing you need to know about the Divine Comedy, not funny.
Sarlacc burning bright for Saracen tonight. Rage, rage against the dying of the light. Do not go gentle into Gladys Knight.
There won't be a quiz.
I can encapsulate each one of these books in a single sentence.
Really?
You can? How much time left?
3 minutes.
Go ahead, test me.
Go.
What do we have? The Origin of Species. We Came from Apes.
Interpretation of Dreams.
I Love My Mother.
That's it?
Oh, I really love my mother.
No. Oh, the Tao!
Now 130 points. That's not a book. You're not the Tao. The Tao.
Oh, the Tao.
Desire Nothing.
Walden.
Simplify Your Life.
Thus Spake Zarathustra.
God is Dead.
1984.
Don't Trust the Government.
Animal Farm.
Don't Trust the Pigs.
The Feminine Mystique.
Don't Trust the Pigs. Silent Spring. Don't Trust Big Business.
Canterbury Tale.
Ooh! Don't Take Long Trips for People Like to Tell Long, Boring Stories.
Alice in Wonderland.
Don't Take Drugs.
On the Road.
Take Drugs. The
Odyssey.
Don't write a book in Greek that nobody can understand.
Ulysses.
Don't write a book in English that nobody can understand.
Heart of Darkness.
He dies at the end.
Camille.
She dies at the end.
Sunset Boulevard.
He dies at the beginning.
The Bible.
Comes back at the end.
Yeah. The Great Gatsby.
Rich people are screwed up.
Thus, Capital.
The workers are screwed.
Oliver Twist.
The workers are screwed.
To Kill a Mockingbird.
The Mockingbirds are screwed.
Picture of Dorian Gray.
Don't be so obsessed with youth.
Moby Dick.
Don't be so obsessed with the whale.
Don Quixote.
Sanity is overrated.
One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest.
Sanity is overrated.
Harry Potter.
No, just overrated.
For Whom the Bell Tolls.
Don't write long sentences.
War and Peace.
Don't write long books.
Star Wars.
Ah, not a book with Darth Vader as his father.
Citizen Kane.
Not a book with Rosebud as his sled.
Dianetics.
Not a good book, but people will buy anything.
Lolita!
Don't be such a pervert!
The Fountainhead!
Don't rely on anybody else!
Death in Venice!
I like that book, now I'm dead!
Crime and Punishment!
I killed that guy, but now I'm dead!
Satanic Mercy!
I wrote that book, I'm almost dead!
Beowulf!
Don't make us read this crap!
Bridges of Madison County!
Don't write this crap!
At all the great books abridged, everybody goes home a winner.
Congratulations, you!
The great thing about this show is that if we do our job right, you'll never have to read another book again.
Called on account of boredom.